Hello, my name is Jeff with Adash, and this is the DDS tutorial video. In this video, I would like to show you how to create the root tree. I've installed and run DDS. Let me describe the basic appearance of DDS now. At the top, there is the main menu with various tabs. To find general settings, go to the Tools tab. Click Global, and you get the Global Settings window. You can change many things here, for example the language. The units can be changed here as well. You can select metric or imperial units according to your needs. To change the sensor sensitivity, click Sensors. Double-click on the sensor line to open the window where you can change the type or the sensor sensitivity. A standard 100 millivolts per G acceleration sensor, type AC150, which is supplied with the Vibrio M kit, is predefined already. Here on the left you can see the tree. You can add, edit, or remove tree items over here. DDS contains the demo root tree after the first run. This root tree has been created just to show you what the typical root tree structure looks like. Let me also explain two basic terms which we will use before we create our own tree. Those terms are tree items and data cells. Tree item is part of the tree and it does not contain measurements. A tree item can be, for example, a whole factory, an individual machine, or a measurement point on the machine. Another type is data cell. A data cell contains measurement settings, for example overalls, spectra, or time waveforms. Typically the data cells are created under the measurement point. Now I would like to describe how to simply create your root tree. I will create factory, department, machine, measurement point, and data cells, or measurements if you wish. I don't need demo tree items, so I'll delete them. I will just leave the Vibrio root tree data cells item. So, let's create our root tree now. We can rename and change the logo of the first demo tree. Let's call it My Company. In the Tree tab, press the Add button. The window with tree item properties appears. I name my factory, select the icon of the factory, and select the sensor. If I define the sensor here on the highest tree item, it will be inherited by all items below it. Click OK to confirm your settings. Click the Add button again, the factory item must be active, or right-click on the factory item and click Add Item. Now I will create a department. So again, I enter the name and select the icon. As you can see, I don't need to select the sensor here again as it was inherited from the factory item above. Click OK to confirm your settings. Click the Add button again to create the machine. The department item must be active. So, I enter the name of the tree item again, this time Machine. Select the icon. And now I need to check the machine checkbox here. This is an indication for DDS that you are not creating just a regular item, for example factory or some department of your factory, but you are creating machine, under which the measurement point will be created. The running checkbox means that this machine is working, and you want to include this machine in your root measurement. Click OK to confirm the settings. Now we will create a measurement point, which will be the place on the machine where the measurement will be taken. So I right-click on the machine and select Add Item again. Again, I need to enter the name. I will call it bearing 1. I can select the icon, and measurement point checkbox has to be checked here this time. This is an indication for DDS that you are creating a measurement point under which the data cells, that means the measurements, will be created. Now we can see the root tree structure. Now I will create data cells for the measurements, or readings if you wish. Data cells contain measurement settings as I mentioned earlier. I will show it on the predefined Vibrio root data cells. This item contains all predefined measurement types which Vibrio AM can measure in the root mode. Now I click on the VEL RMS data cell, which stands for Velocity RMS. Right click, select Properties, and I can see the properties list of this data cell. This means that with the VEL RMS data cell, we will be measuring the overall value in velocity, millimeters per second, RMS, in the 10 to 1000 Hz frequency range. You can click on any data cell's properties to see its settings. Let's say that we want to measure velocity RMS, acceleration RMS, and velocity FFT under our bearing 1 measurement point. I will use the multi-edit function. I'm holding control and selecting the data cells which I want to drag and drop. Then I simply drag the selected cells to bearing 1. We can see the plus symbol next to the mouse arrow. A window appears, so I can select whether I am copying or moving the data cell. I press OK to confirm copying the data cells. With the drag and drop function, you can also copy the whole measurement point with your data cells. I will drag and drop bearing 1 to machine 1 and rename it bearing 2. You can also copy the whole machine. Drag and drop it on the major tree item and rename it machine 2. So now we have the tree with two machines. And each of them has two measurement points and three data cells under each point. Now I will show you how to transfer the created root into the Vibrio AM. I go to the Root tab and click on the A4900 Vibrio AM instrument symbol. Two new windows appear for roots and for the A4900 Vibrio AM device. I want to add my new root to the list of roots. I will transfer the tree which I created, so I drag and drop the factory icon into the roots window. I can edit the name of the root. The root will be saved to the roots window and will stay there until I delete it. So now I want to get the root to the Vibrio AM measuring device. First, I simply drag and drop the created root from the roots window into the A4900 Vibrio AM window. I can see my root called factory here. I switch on the Vibrio AM and connect it to the PC with the USB cable supplied. I activate my factory root, it has to be blue, and click the send button. The window with the notification about memory erasing will appear. Only one root can be saved in the Vibrio AM memory at one time. I confirm by clicking OK, and then my root is loaded to the Vibrio AM. You should see the USB picture on the Vibrio AM once it connects with DDS. I unplug the USB cable from the Vibrio AM once the root is loaded into the unit. So now I can go and measure my root. Once I've measured my root, I can transfer the data into my root tree. Connect the Vibrio AM to the PC through the USB cable. click on the Receive button. Activate the route which has been transferred from the Vibrio M device and click the Store button. Go to the Graph tab, and by clicking on the required data cells, you can see a preview of the measured data. You can see that the data cell text have changed color from gray to black. This means that the data cells now contain data. Thank you for watching this video.